Let's face it, bugs suck. They sting us, bite us, infect us, and frankly, they just annoy us in general. Bugs aren't only annoying, they spread diseases that kill hundreds of thousands of people every year. But would we really be better off without them? Hello, and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, what if all the bugs died? There are a lot of insects on planet Earth. There are 7 billion people on planet Earth, and insects outnumber humans by at least 1,000 to 1. You do the math. Insects were one of the first animals to transition from sea to land. They were around way before the dinosaurs, some 170 million years before. There would definitely be some pros if all the bugs died. Mosquito-borne diseases like malaria and dengue fever infect millions of people on this planet every year. Fleas terrorize our pets. Bedbugs and termites infiltrate our homes. Without bugs, all of those issues would disappear. If there were no insects, farmers wouldn't have to use insecticides anymore. 500 million pounds of chemicals are sprayed on plants in the United States alone every year to prevent crops from being eaten. Insecticides control pests, yes, but they can poison people and get into water supplies. Not to mention, they are really bad for the environment. But if there were no more insects, there would also be very few plants in the first place. Truthfully, without bugs, the world would begin to fall apart. Around 80% of the plants on Earth are angiosperms, which are flowering plants that need to be pollinated by, you guessed it, insects. Insects physically transfer pollen from a male anther to a female stigma inside a flower. Yes, animals and birds can pollinate plants as well, but the majority of pollination is done by insects, like bees, butterflies, and beetles. Without insects, most plants on Earth would disappear, and that poses a big problem. Plants make up anywhere from 50 to 90% of the human diet, and plants also feed the animals and birds we eat. What are 7 billion people going to eat if most plants and animals disappear? If all the bugs died, that sets off a domino effect, where the end result is the starvation of most life on Earth. Bugs also assist fungi in decomposing organic matter, like carcasses. Without bugs to help along the decomposition, dead bodies and dead trees will linger around much longer, likely causing the spread of disease. Without bugs, we would have none of the things produced by bugs either. That means no honey and definitely no silk. Honey and silk have been around since the beginning of human history. Can you imagine a world without either of those things? And the scary part is, bees are already dying off at an alarming rate, and so are many other insects. Thanks to pesticides, disease, and habitat loss, many insect populations are declining, especially that of honeybees. Honeybees are extremely vital. They pollinate 70 of the 100 crop species that feed 90% of the world. To break it down, honeybees are responsible for $30 billion worth of crops every year. Humans are affecting insect populations in other ways as well. Climate change is affecting the hatching of insects and blooming flowers in the spring. Insects need to hatch within weeks of flowers first beginning to bloom in order for fertilization to occur. Climate change is throwing off that delicate balance, and hatchlings are missing the flowers by weeks. Even pesky mosquitoes have a role to play. They are easy for predators to catch, and they're apparently delicious. Lizards, frogs, fish, spiders, and other insects rely on mosquitoes as a primary food source. So, to wrap it up, even though bugs are annoying and sometimes deadly, if they died off, we would be in a terrible position. Thank you so much for watching this video until the end. On the screen right now, you will see a link to our Patreon, where you can donate as little as a few dollars to Life's Biggest Questions. There are different perks depending on how much you would like to donate, so check out the link to find out what they are, and also to find out what the hosts of LBQ look like. I know you want to! And if you want to continue watching Life's Biggest Questions, check out our video, What If the Internet Was Never Invented?